So greetings, Fulton families. I am so excited to be here today while we are discussing our textbook adoption process. Not only is it just the textbook adoption process, it is the textbook adoption process for ELA. For those that do not know me, I'm Dr. Jima Whitaker. I have the pleasure to serve as the Deputy Chief Academic Officer here in Fulton, and I am joined by two literacy experts in our district. So first, Ms. Burson, would you go ahead and introduce yourself?
Hi, everyone. My name is Jennifer Burton, and I am the Literacy Director for kindergarten through fifth grade.
Excellent. So great to have you here today. And also, Ms. Webb, would you go ahead and introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Kelly Webb, and I'm the ELA director for grades 6 through 12. And I'm happy to be here with you guys.
Awesome. I'm happy to have both of you here because the textbook adoption process is very important. And if you would please tell our audience, why is it important for the school district to review our textbooks or even adopt them on a regular basis?
So according to Fulton County Board Policy, IAC, the Board of Education adopts textbooks to support the implementation of the Fulton County Schools accepted standards. It is essential that instructional programs and resources align with the standards in this curriculum. Typically, Fulton County reviews and adopts textbooks every 6 to 7 years. The last time Fulton County Schools implemented new ELA textbooks was during the 2013-14 school year. The K-2 textbook adoption was postponed last year so that we could use our letters learning to inform the selection process.
Awesome. So when we think about this, what was the initial selection process?
The process of selecting the curriculum resource began with identifying the unique literacy needs of Fulton County Schools, as well as reviewing the science of reading research through that letters professional learning. The district's literacy directors and ELA program specialists reviewed textbooks from multiple states that aligned their curriculum to the science of reading, as well as reviewed reports from Ed Reports. Based on this information, the ELA team narrowed down the resources to 4 to 5 core textbook series, as well as some elementary pillar-specific programs for the textbook committee to review. The district's literacy directors and program specialists then developed a district rubric based on the science of reading and rubrics from Ed Reports, as well as the Regional Education Laboratory, also known as REL, at Florida State University to evaluate these narrowed selections.
So who was on our textbook committee?
The textbook committee consisted of a variety of stakeholders within Fulton County who represented all zones and included a zone superintendent, principals, assistant principals, a CST, literacy coach, teachers, the literacy director, and literacy program specialists.
Wow, that's a lot of people. I'm glad that we did have such a variety of instructional leaders and also experts in the field. So how did the textbook committee determine the selections that are now out for our public to review?
So the textbook committee, which, as Jennifer mentioned, included the ELA team, reviewed each of the narrowed selections using the district-created rubric. Some of the key components of the rubric included instructional design, text quality and complexity, and building knowledge. The elementary rubric also included the 5 pillars of reading. After reviewing the materials, each committee member independently rated each textbook option. The results of the committee's ratings were used to determine the selections that are now available for public review.
Wow, that's a lot of work that has gone into that. So that's very exciting. So what are the final choices that are being presented for our public to review?
Our final pillar-specific programs for public review are Hegarty for K-2, 95 Core for K through 3, Vocabulary Surge for 4 through 5. Our final elementary core textbooks for public review are McGraw-Hill's Wonders for K through 5 and Savvis My View K through 5. For secondary, the final textbooks and pillar-specific programs for public review are Into Literature by HMH, My Perspectives by Savvis, Springboard by College Board, and Words Their Way as a pillar-specific program for vocabulary for reading and ELA high school support classes. The final AP resources for public review are Bedford, Freeman, and Worth, and AMSCO AP.
I am really intrigued by how you keep saying the pillar. It's according to the pillar, because when we think about what we want our students to learn in literacy, it's definitely according to those pillars. So this is very exciting. So our public is now going to review all of these different resources according to the pillars, but their next step is to provide us some feedback. So how do they provide the feedback for those resources?
Yes, we really value the input of all of our community stakeholders, parents, and teachers. So we encourage you to review these materials. And you can review the physical materials of the grade K through 5 resources at all elementary schools, the grade 6 through 8 resources at all middle schools, and the grade 9 through 12 resources at all high schools. You can also view all grade K through 12 resources in 3 of our district offices, the North Learning Center, the Administrative Building, and the South Learning Center. In addition to the physical materials, you can also review digital materials of all of these resources on our ELA textbook adoption page, which can be found on the Fulton County Schools website. Teachers, parents, and community members also have the opportunity to view presentations from all of the publishers. These presentations will be held throughout the month of December and January, including the January 3rd Teacher Workday. And these sessions will be held on Microsoft Teams, so they are virtual, and information about where to find these meeting links can be found on that website. And finally, parents and community stakeholders will also have the opportunity to view presentations from all vendors being considered for adoption on Saturday, January 8th, as well as during the evenings of Monday, January 11th, and Tuesday, January 12th. And at all of these sites, there will be a link and a QR code where the public can provide their feedback in a survey regarding these materials. So please review that Fulton County Schools website for additional details as well as links to these presentations.
Wow, so that pillar specific resource is basically all throughout Fulton. You could go to any school, you could go to any administrative building, and then in the month of January, there will also be some vendor presentations. This is very exciting. When we think about what literacy will be and how this process can be so transformative for our schools and also for our students in the future, I thank you. I thank both of you for your work and for our community, for our teachers, for our families, for our administrators. Please go out, look at these resources, give us your feedback, because we want this textbook adoption selection process to be one where we walk away with the best fit for our district. So thank you so much for tuning in. And that's just a little bit about our textbook selection process, specifically for literacy. Thanks. Bye-bye.